عليه الصلاة والسلام. Alayhi salatu wasalam was the best example when it came to everything, sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And he led by an example. And the Sahaba after him were the greatest of people who followed his path, sallallahu alayhi wasalam. During the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was a khalifa, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the most powerful man on the surface of this earth. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the head of the Muslim state. And what happens? Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu loses his shield, his armor. So while he was walking in the market, he finds his shield behind a table of a Jewish man that's selling it. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu lost his shield, his armor. And while he was in the market, he found this Jewish man selling it. So Ali ibn Abi Talib told him, "This is my shield." So the Jewish man says, "No, it's my shield and it's in my hands." So Ali ibn Abi Talib, what does he do? He's got the authority to do whatever he wants. He's the head of state. He's the most powerful man on the surface of this earth. This after the Islamic State had expanded and so on. Ali ibn Abi Talib is going to say, get the guards and get him and lock this man up. But Ali ibn Abi Talib didn't do that. Why? Because Islam does not tell him to do that. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the head of the Islamic State, the Khalifa, will take this Jewish man and go to Qadi Shuraih, will go to the judge in a court and stand under the judge's podium or the table, and he stands in front of the judge, and his opponent is a Jewish man, and Shuraih, the Qadi, the judge Shuraih, will ask Ali, what's your matter? So Ali will say that this shield in the hands of this Jewish man belongs to me. So the Shuraih will say to the Jewish man, where did you get this shield from? The Jewish man will say, no, it belongs to me and it's in my hands. So he will look at Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Khalifa, will say to him, do you have witnesses? So Ali ibn Abi Talib, he says, I've got only my son. So the Qadi, the judge, says, your son is not acceptable to be a witness to his father. A son is not accepted to be a witness to his father. So he looks at the Jewish man and he gives the rights for the Jewish man to keep the shield. He made a judgment. He made a judgment for the Jewish man, because Ali, the Khalifa, the one that would not even lie. The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum do not lie. They are just an udul. And this is Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, from the greatest of people. And there Shuraih will say to Ali, sorry, it's the Jewish man's, is the shield belongs to the Jewish man. When the Jewish man saw this justice, Allahu Akbar, this justice is not justice of mankind. This is the justice of above mankind, and that's Islam. He said, wallahi, I took this shield when it fell down from Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and I took it and now it's in my hand. I want to give it back to Ali, because these are the manners of prophets and messengers. And he said, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, because you are my Muslim brother, now take this shield as a present. Where is this justice? Didn't have this hatred and grudge. He's a kafir, step on his head. He's a kafir, don't even give him the time of the time of the essence. He's a kafir, don't even look at him. That's not Islam. We mix our grudges and hatred and personal issues with Islam. We as Muslims, we are here to invite people to Islam. Abu Bakr was a kafir. Umar was a kafir. All the Sahaba were kuffar. And now they are the greatest of examples. We should wish, wallahi, we should wish the best thing for them. And the best thing for them is Islam.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه